Hi students, this is Tara Ravishankar, Assistant Professor in Department of Media Studies, Christnagar College, Trivandrum. Welcome to our cinema class. And here onwards, Malayalam cinema got split into two distinct streams. One as the artistic cinema and the other one is the commercial cinema. The artistic cinema's primary objective was to keep away from the commercial strands, that means the kind of popularity, the formulas and all. And commercial cinema, it considers the possibility of spending money. And that was happening after this P.N. Menon's cinema. And most of the films during 1960s were animated by ran nationalist and socialist projects and centered on issues relating to caste and class exploitation. The fight against the beliefs, the generation, degeneration of the feudal class and the breakups of the joint family, all these were portrayed during 60s. Like M. Krishnan Nair, Kunjaku and Subramaniam were the leading producers. You know about the Maryland studio by Subramaniam. Subramaniam passed away recently and Kunjaku's Udaya Studio in Alappi, and Thikkurishi Sukumaran Nayar, Prem Nasir, Satyan, Madhu, Adur Bhasi, Bahadur, S.P. Pilla, K.P. Ummar, Kottarakara Sridharan Nayar, Raghavan, G.K. Pilla, Mudugulam, Mudugulam Raghavan Pilla, Jose Prakash, Paravur Bharathan, Muthaiya, or then Shankaradi, Govindankutty, then K.R. Vijaya, Patmini, Ragini, Sharada, Lalitha Padmini Ragini were known as Travancore sisters, Sharada, Sheila, Ambiga, Jayabharathi, Aramula Ponnamma. So many actors, very versatile, very talented actors, actresses came up during this time. During 1950s, 60s and 70s, Kunjaku made significant contribution to Malayalam films, both as a producer and as a director of some notable films. He started Udaya Studio in Alappi, Alappuzha in 1947, reducing the travel to Madras or Chennai, the now known Chennai, for film crew and actors. He boosted Malayalam film production in Kerala, and that was a notable change in Malayalam film industry. Many directors sprang up in this period. And you know about the P.N. Menon, who made this Olum Thirum, came up with another cinema, Rosi, and later Chemparathi. Then Aravindan and Adur Gopalakrishnan, who started working in 1960s, and they become famous during this time. And Adur Gopalakrishnan made a great change in Malayalam film industry. I told you, the parallel cinema, which was accelerated by the Olum Thirum, it's all around 1970, because late 1967 it happened, and it was that reflection was going on in 1970s. The emergence of a new wave of cinema in Malayalam was happening then, and introducing the works of French and Italian directors, like not Italian New Wave, it was Italian Neorealist and French New Wave, okay. And Adur Gopalakrishnan Swayamvaram, that was a notable cinema. The film institute passed out a new category of filmmakers. They were turning to film making, and that was a change happening in Malayalam cinema. The Malayalam New Wave, the growth of film society movement and the screening of world classics posed a drastic change in Malayalam film sensitivity during 1970s. A new movement offered a time called a new wave Malayalam cinema or Malayalam parallel cinema. Adur Gopalakrishnan made first film Swayamvaram in 1972 and made Malayalam cinema notice that international film arena. G. Aravindan, through his Uttarayanam in 1974, accelerated this radical change in Malayalam cinema. Medieval age of Malayalam cinema, that happened during 1970s and 1980s. The Malayalam film makers were active in film festivals during that time. I could see an important author in Malayalam cinema, M.T. Vasudevan Nair. He won the President's Golden Medal for the best film during this time. And you could see some of the notable directors. One is G. Aravindan. You can see him on the right side. Aravindan followed Adur Gopalakrishnan with the Uttarayanam in 1974. And Aravindan was famous in Kerala as a cartoonist in Madhurbhumi Weekly. He started making films. His famous films were Kanjana Sida, Thambu, Kummati and all, Chidambaram, 1985, Uridatta, and then Vastuhara in 1990. All these were Aravindan's notable films. 70s saw the emergence of a new wave of cinema in Malayalam. That was what we are talking about. The growth of film society movement in Kerala introduced the work of French and Italian new wave directors to Malayalam film, new kind of film making. That was happening in 1970s. Adur Gopalakrishnan Swayamvaram, I already told. And Malayalam's M.T. Vasudevan Nair. He was recognized as an important author in Malayalam cinema during this time. His first film, Nirmalyam, which won the National Award for the Best Feature Film, happened during this time. G. Aravindan, who followed Adur Gopalakrishnan, also came up during this time. And K.P. Kumaran, his Atithi in 1974. K.P. Kumaran is another notable director, cinematographer who won the National Award for their work on Malayalam films in 1970s, where Mangada Revivarma for Swayamvaram 1972. That means the cinematographer of Swayamvaram, Mangada Revivarma, and P.S. Nivas for Mohiniyattam. There is a mistake in the spelling, kindly correct it. Mohiniyattam. And Shaji N. Karun for Thambu, 1979. John Abraham, K.R. Mohan, K.G. George, all were the popular directors. G.S. Panikkar were products of the Pune Film Institute, who made a drastic change in Malayalam film industry during that time. And you know about the medieval film industry, things were changing during this time. I told you, 1970s, 80s, medieval age of films in Malayalam starts and gets started. And Malayalam film was classified into three. One is art or parallel cinema. The second one is middle stream cinema, that is Madhyavarti cinema. And the third one is commercial or popular or mainstream cinema. So first classification is art cinema or parallel cinema. Second category is middle stream cinema. And third category is commercial or popular cinema. Even if films in art genre or commercial genre existed long before, a clear-cut classification came forward with the introduction of middle stream cinema. That means Madhyavarti cinema. And this was a synthesis of highly commercial popular cinema and the parallel cinema. And these films, mainly directors like K.G. George, Padmarajan, Bharathan, they were the people behind middle stream cinema, which stand between the art cinema and commercial cinema, having the qualities from both the genres. Some people, they don't like to call this classification. They only say, like Adur Gopalakrishnan, he wished to say that they were only good cinema and bad cinema. It's right to a great sense. And film society movement in Kerala is another important thing. The film society movement, which was started in 1960s and gained momentum during 1970s. We have already talked about film societies, right? Or you may be having a class on film society soon, and brought in a new consciousness about cinema through the film society movement as a kind of art form, and stood for a different kind of cinema, which was termed as parallel, new wave or art cinema. Contrary to other parts of India, this film society movement was never an urban phenomena, but something that cut across all terrains and sections of society at a point of time. The great classics of world cinema reached even the rural Kerala, and discussions on them were held at layman's level. That was a speciality what was going on in Kerala. The Chitralekha Film Society, formed under the leadership of Adur Gopalakrishnan and Kulathur Bhaskaran Nair. Who are the people? Adur Gopalakrishnan and Kulathur Bhaskaran Nair, and behind Chitralekha Film Society, which was formed in Trivandrum in 1965. And it was the first film society in Kerala. Through even before that, there were film societies, like in Thrissur, there were film clubs, namely Thrissur Film Club in 1955. But that was not like Chitralekha. Chitralekha also did work towards formation of film societies in schools and colleges, and also succeeded in getting up a film studio of its own. Soon, film societies were formed at different parts of Kerala. The Naxalbari agitations, student revolts in Paris, Vietnam War, hippie movement. They formed the great ambience to cinema in 1970s. The agitated movie environment combined with the Malayalam literary scene, which was already vibrant with the new modernist ideas, become the foundation for the spread of film societies all over Kerala during 1970s. More than 100 film societies sprouted all over Kerala, of which some of them have completed even 24 years, more than 24 years now. And Kerala has the largest number of film societies in India and still trying to create awareness about cinema as a serious art form. Among the film societies of Kerala, the Odessa experiment by John Abraham stands apart from the experiments in various ways. That means it never had a formal legal structure or any political backing. Its attempt was to attack the problem comprehensively at all levels, like exhibition, distribution, and production, by ensuring people's participation in all its activities. But with the untimely demise of John Abraham, Odessa experiment was vanished. It ruined, actually. And we were talking about the cinema of 1970s. You could see the popular cinemas made during this time. Vishwambaran, P.G. Vishwambaran, another notable director of 1970s. His first film was Olukkinethire. And a mythical film, that means Satyavan Savitri by P.G. Vishwambaran. And also commercial cinema in this period. So several worker class themed films like having N.G. Soman, Sukumaran and Sudhir in the lead roles. And that means they push a new kind of action themed films in Malayalam cinema. You know about the Jayan Tarangam, right? A movement led by star Jayan, who is usually considered as the first genuine commercial superstar of Malayalam cinema industry. However, this was short-lived and almost end with Jayan's untimely death while performing a stunt in Kolilakkam in 1980. And that was Jayan. Still, people have a great influence by Jayan. You know about mimicry people or people who love cinema, they imitate Jayan. They try to imitate Jayan. Jayan made a great change in the kind of action cinema in Malayalam. And when talking about 80s, definitely I'll talk more on Adurgo Balakrishnan. His Elipatha in 1981, that is a notable cinema. And this movie was widely acclaimed and won the British Film Institute Award. Other important films of that period was Mukhamukam, Anandaram, Madhilugal, Vidheyan, Kadhapurushan, Nidalkuthu, like that. We have already talked on Adur Gobalakrishnan as a separate session. We could see some of the famous directors like Padmarajan. Padmarajan is one of my favorite filmmaker. He could be classified as a filmmaker of this middle stream cinema in Malayalam. Malayalam Madhivati cinemayude oru vaktavana. Padmarajan made his early works in this period during the movie or his Koodavide in 1983. Koodavide is a beautiful cinema, and this if you get time, kindly watch all these films. His important films were Peruvazhi Ambalam, 1979. Peruvazhi Ambalam, the main character was done by Ashokan, Nadan Ashokan, and Oridathoru Fileman, 1981. And then Thingalaazha Nalla Divasam, 1985. Namukku Paarkkan Mundirathoppukal, based on Solomon Sutthamagidam. You could see some of the verses of Solomon Sutthamagidam in Namukku Paarkkan Mundirathoppukal, 1986. And Deshadana Kili Karayarilla, 1986. Arappetta Kettiya Gramathil, then 1986. That was Padmarajan. That was not Padmarajan. You have to know more on Padmarajan. I'm just briefing all those things. The golden age or new age of Malayalam cinema was coming by that time. That means the Malayalam cinema of this period was characterized by detailed screenplays dealing with everyday life with a lucid narration of plot intermingling with humor and melancholy. And this was aided by cinematography and lighting. The film had a warm background music. In 1981, Fasil directed Manjil Virinja Pookal, Adur Gopalakrishnan made Elipathayam in 1981. This movie won the British Film Institute Award also, Elipathayam. That was Elipathayam. K.G. George released films including Yavaniga, Adaminte Vaariyal. This was the period during which script writer M.T. Vasudevan Nayar, started teaming with director Hariharan to produce films like Panjagni, Nakshadangal, Aranyagam, or Vadakkan Veeragatha. Aranyagam was a film starring Devan, that was a wonderful film about a kind of what agitation and all was discussed in cinema. And John Abraham's film such as Ammayariyan addressed people's issue and raised the finance directly from people. That was a product of People's from Odessa movement by John Abraham. We have already mentioned the Odessa movement, right? And the new age of Malayalam cinema, most critics and audience consider 80s and 90s as the golden age of Malayalam cinema. The Malayalam cinema of this period was characterized by detailed screenplays. That was the most important change that was happening in Malayalam cinema during this time. And this was aided by brilliant cinematography and lighting too. You know about the films like Perinthachan, 1990, by Ajayan. Ajayan was a filmmaker who did a very few films. That is Perinthachan alone. And Santhoshivan was doing the cast cinematography. And these films are also remembered for the warm background music also, like the music composer Johnson was coming up during this time, Johnson Marsh. And Namukku Parkan Mundiri Thoppukal by Padmarajan is another important film. Popular cinema of Malayalam cinema, rarely they try to adopt the language of cinema till 1980s. Delivering highly dramatic dialogues and singing and dancing sequences inside the cinema. But this was changing during this time. And a stage was a new kind of acceptance was going on to Malayalam commercial cinema. Things were changing during this time. By 1990s, I think things were moving in a different way. The period had movies with the humor from the humor, that means director like Padmarajan, Sathya Nandikad, Kamal, Siddiq. And the Piravi, that was a notable film, which and apart from all these films which we are discussing on, that like commercial film or the comedy films, Piravi is a notable film made by Shaji and Karun, the first Malayalam film to win the Cannes d'Or award, mentioned at Cannes Film Festival. It was the a period during Mohanlal and Mammootty rose up, and then talking about films in during that time, you know about the films made by Joshi and all, that means The Moorkhan 1980, Rektham 1981, Sambhavam 1981, all were made in same old format pioneered with Malayalam commercial films. The New Delhi 1987, Nayar Saab 1989, Patram 1999, that was Joshi. And Fasil also. Fasil is another super duper director. Even he created success with without superstars. About Manjil Virinja Pukal, 1980. He introduced Mohanlal through the cinema. And Thiranotam was a film before that. But Manjil Virinja Pukal through this film, Mohanlal as a villain, he got a notable position in Malayalam cinema industry. And Mamati Kutti Ammaki, where Baby Shalini, there were films portraying Baby Shalini around stories revolving around Baby Shalini and Baby Shamali, sisters, emphasized maternal love and all. And Nokata Durath Kandam Nattu, another film by Fasil, 1983, Ende Surya Putraki, 1991, Manichitra Thaal, 1993. All their trend-setting films. And I have to talk about I.V. Shashi, another notable director of 1970s, 80s. That was I.V. Shashi. He started with Ulsavam, 1975, a small budget film with no stars. And since his film's form has undergone several transformations and succeeded in almost all of them. Avalude Ravugal, 1979, that was a notable film which made a history in the popular Malayalam cinema. That means a kind of soft porn movies was coming up with the cinema. And I.V. Shashi started with a star, that means like Angadi, and a series of big budget films also came up from him, I.V. Shashi. Angadi was a successful film. And Trishna in 1981, Ragam, Anubandham, Alkootathil Thaniye 1984, with a screenplay of M.T. Vasudevan Nair. Then you know about Eenad, Vartha, Avanadi 1986 with the screenplays of T. Dhamodaran. And I.V. Shashi's film 1921, that was a modern film which was made in 1988. That was a historical cinema. And you know about the Balachandra Menon. Balachandra Menon was a he himself is a trendsetter. He is a cinema journalist, and he turned to be a director who has made several popular films like Ishtamanu Pakshi 1980, Karyam Saram 1983, Prashnam Gurudaram 1983, April Padanetta, which introduced Shobana 1984. These films are mostly humorous films with down-to-earth characters. Achyuvettan Devide 1987, he tried to take a new path, and Samandarangal 1997 was critically acclaimed cinema and won him the National Award for Best Actor. Many of the movies released during this time narrowed the gap between art cinema and commercial cinema in Malayalam cinema. As in Oru Vadakkan Veeragatha 1989, you could see, classify it as a commercial cinema or art cinema. These were paralleled with Kiridam 1989, directed by Sibi Malayil. You know what the cinema Taniyavartanam, Lohit Das, Sibi Malayil Kootukettil, they made so many films. Mathilugal, you know about Adur Gopalakrishnan, on the basis of the Vaikam Muhammad Bashir, 1989, Mathilugal. Then Amaram, directed by Bharathan. Kakothi Kavile Appuppan Thaadikal, 1988, directed by Kamal. And Sargam, 1992, directed by Hariharan. That is beautiful film. There were so many musical films like Hizainas Abdullah, Bharatham, Sargam. All these were popular movies of that time, which give emphasis to classical music category. And like Kamaladalam, you know about the Kamaladalam, right? Kamaladalam gave importance to classical dance. Mohanlal performed the character of a classical dancer, Bharatanatyam dancer, which was portrayed in and around this. Premises were Kalamandalam, Kerala Kalamandalam, and Monisha Parvati acting in this film. And the period had an abundance of movies rich in creative humor from directors like Priyadarshan, Satyanambikad, Kamal and all. You know about the films made by the duo Siddhik Lal Kootukatta, Ramju Rao Speaking 1989, In Harihar Nagar 1990, and another notable films were there were some films like Abhayam, directed by Shivan, the movie Daisy 1988, an expressive depiction of separation and longing set in boarding school, directed by Pratap K. Pothan, that was Daisy. And commercial success like Rajasenan, Vinayan, Bhadran, Anil Babu, and Thambi Kannandanam, T.S. Suresh Babu. T.S. Suresh Babu's film, Kottai Kunnyachan. Oh, what a wonderful movie. These were some notable films of that time. Were arousing some political thoughts. And like Satyanandikad came up with this Sandesham, a political melodrama. It was a satirical film. That were really interesting movies of that time, 1990s. You could see some of the films also, yeah, Ulladakkam by Kamal, Kilukkam, Priyadarshan Kilukkam, you know about the Vidhayan, directed by Adur Gopalakrishnan, Devasuram, I.V. Shashi's Devasuram, we have talked about Manchirthaadu, then Pondan Mada, K. പി വി ചന്ദ്രൻ സ്പന്ദൻമാട, സ്ഫടികം ബൈ ഭദ്രൻ, കമ്മീഷണർ ദ കിങ് ബൈ ഷാജി കൈലാസ്. ഷാജി കൈലാസ് വാസ് എ ഫ്രണ്ട്സ് അറ്റ് അവൻ വൺ ടൈം ബിക്കോസ് ഹി വാസ് മേക്കിംഗ് സോ മെനി ആക്ഷൻ ഫിലിംസ് ഇൻ മലയാളം. And about the Siddiq's Hitler, Desharnam, Jayaraj, another notable director in Malayala cinema, his Navarasa series, Hyasim is coming up in new IFFK. Last IFFK portrayed Bhayanagam, so that was based on the Kerala flood and all. The Jayaraj, Desharnam was a popular cinema during this 1990s. And in 1997 it released Swam, directed by Shaji and Karun, it was the first film which gave film entry for the competition in Cannes Film Festival, where it was a nomination for Palm d'Or. And you know about the Murali Nair's Marana Simhasanam, later won Camera d'Or in 1999 Cannes Film Festival. And know about the Guru. Guru was a beautiful cinema in 1997. When I was a child, there were so many child artists coming through Guru, and they claimed that I acted in Guru because there were lot of kids acting in Guru. So when I am going for some shooting and all, some people talk, she acted in this movie and that is Guru. When I watched the cinema, oh, I wonder, where is she? Because there are so many people working in Guru. Guru was such an opening for a batch of newcomers, and that was by Rajiv Anjal, who was chosen as India's official entry to Oscar, Guru. And that was the specialty of Guru. And considered for nomination, and it was some part of the Guru was set in Chitranjali Studio here in Trivandrum. I was going behind that memories of Guru. And best foreign film category for the year, and making it the first film in Malayalam to be chosen for Oscar. And we have already discussed all these films, right?
Students, we come to the end of our session. Next day, we will continue our journey through Malayalam cinema. Thank you for listening to me. Signing off your teacher, Tara Ravishankar.